Welcome to another episode of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. I'm your host, Swetha Mannepalli. Today, I have a special focus for you guys, where we are bringing in customer to talk about how they leveraged Microsoft Fabric, specifically in the translytical world of SQL Server and databases. So I have here today, Jacob Jensen from AP Pension. Welcome to our show.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Jacob, before we get into the details, do you want to introduce yourself, what you do at AP Pension, and also what AP Pension does as an organization?
Exactly. I'm Jacob, as you said, and head of data and integration. So I have two teams that I work with. One is the data platform team, which is the primary focus of what I'm going to be talking about today. And the other one is this integration, like moving data around between operational systems. So I've been there for 2 years, and we've been building Fabric for about a year, and we actually went live with Fabric in April, did a production assessment together with the product team, and we're actually that is our main analytical platform in AP Pension.
Thank you so much for being one of the early adopters for Microsoft Fabric as well. So tell us a little more about how did you arrive to the decision of using Microsoft Fabric, and what was the problem you were trying to solve for AP Pension?
So AP Pension, I usually say that we are we're small enough and regulated enough that we have some very complex data issues that we have to deal with, but we're also small enough that we can take some fairly agile decisions. We have a Microsoft first strategy and a going towards 2030. So when I came to the company in 2023, we had multiple platforms all over the place using a lot of different Microsoft technologies. But having a 2030 strategy and wanting to consolidate everything in one platform, Microsoft Fabric was definitely the way to go.
Easy choice, organic choice to start.
Organic choice, and I've been on the program since early Trident days, so I was kind of selling myself in on that platform.
that is great to know. Great story, Jacob. Now. Before, I know you arrived at Microsoft Fabric, it was a natural choice for you. Now, what was the problem statement that made you arrive at, okay, SQL databases in Fabric is the one that will solve it for us?
Yeah, that's kind of a longer story. I'll have to start somewhere else.
Absolutely. But
if you can just kind of describe who we are, and maybe the most important point here is that we are about 600 employees. And we are at an amazing growth rate right now, and everything is based on data. So as a pension company, all you have is data. We don't have a physical product. So working with these data is something that we really want to kind of spread out and make maybe it's a overused term, but democratizing data. But if you look at the usage from those 600 users, you can see that we have about 300 users actually accessing data within the last 2 weeks or before I came here. But the problem that we saw was that in the way that we wanted to work with data, we ended up spinning up a lot of different workspaces. And what we needed to do was find a good way to manage those workspaces. And in that, Fabric SQL bases has actually ended up playing a role.
Okay, wonderful. Now, at Fabric Tech Talk Fridays, Jacob, we always say, let's get to the laptop and show us what you got. Do you have a demo for us today?
I have a demo, but I have to go around some workspaces first.
Absolutely.
So actually, I had the great fortune of working together with Peter Steinhold during our the building of this and during his last book, I actually got to write a chapter on this.
Wonderful.
On building medallion architectures. Not that I'm going to go much into it, but the interesting thing is that because One Lake Security was not there, mm-hmm. what we're actually doing is we're building a lot of different workspaces where we make the data available through shortcuts. So when you do that, you end up having to build a lot of things and have to administrate a lot of different things. So in our target architecture, we'd been working with write back to SQL Server for a long time, but outside of Fabric. That gave us a lot of problems with private endpoints and setting up stuff and getting data into Fabric and stuff like that. So my engineers sat down one day and said, well, wouldn't it be great if that metadata part that is the bottom left corner, if we can move that inside of Fabric and get the full benefit of having it there. So I usually get asked, like, why a SQL Server? Why not just write it to one lake or doing something like that? So the first problem is the framework that we were using and wanted to use for this type of operational load where we want to enter metadata and kind of let a data steward say, I want to create this metadata for this for creating a workspace or something like that. That becomes a transactional or operational workload. And we really want to have the referential integrity, making sure that we can spin up things with the correct naming conventions and don't spin up an orphaned workspace all of a sudden for something that doesn't work. So when you're in Fabric and you're in Delta Lake, it doesn't support the enforcement of keys or foreign keys and stuff like that. You can get that in a database. And just a lot of other big advantages. But when you're inside of the Fabric SQL, not just the ordinary SQL, you also get the mirroring at the same time, and you're inside kind of the Microsoft backbone network. So all these private endpoints and stuff like that, you don't need to do that. So what we're actually doing, the whole thing that we want to do is we want to have a data steward being able to enter some data into a metadata system and make sure that makes data available for the data analyst out in their workspaces. So what we actually do is in Power BI, they can enter data without knowing what they're doing, which starts a pipeline, which goes out, starts a notebook. This notebook then figures out to get a service principal for actually handling being the owner of all the artifacts in our workspace. So we don't have people owning artifacts in these workspaces, so we don't have to kind of manage ownership of this. And then it spins up when we run the pipelines, it actually goes out and it creates the workspaces, creates the shortcuts, creates the artifacts. So as you said, you wanted a demo of some kind? Well,
this is great. If I understand correctly, were you doing the reverse ETL in a way?
Yeah. Okay. So what I have in this demo is actually that it kind of handles all our naming conventions and stuff like that. So we have users who doesn't know anything, who can go into a Power BI report and actually enter some metadata in there. And this metadata in there is then written down to a SQL database, as you can see now on the screen, that actually is inside of Fabric. And when you open it up, it has kind of a table for workspaces, a table for lakehouses, a table for shortcuts, and then it has relations between the different tables. And what this does is that when you go in and you begin entering data into the stuff, we can have computed columns in here that actually enforces our naming conventions on the data set below, so that when you spin up a new workspace, and you can see it here, this is a Power BI report where I go in. We've been working together with a local partner who's also here, Acrobat. But you can actually go in and say, I want to create a new workspace. Fill out some fields, and then when you say I want to commit this and run it, it actually spins up the workspace at the other end, this making sure that naming conventions and everything is standard.
This is great. Thank you so much for sharing this story with us, Jacob. What is that one key takeaway that you would want to leave for customers or partners who are trying to either test Fabric or wanted to know what is the advantage of using SQL databases in a translytical analogy, if I can say so? What is that one key takeaway that you want to leave with?
The key takeaway is that if you want to do write back and you have a lot of small entries, handling the small file problem in Data Lake can be cumbersome. Mm-hmm. an SQL base kind of handles that. And if you at the same time want to handle the referential integrity in your databases as you many times want to when you're kind of building a framework, then the SQL databases do a lot of stuff. But figure out your use case and see which one fits the best. We've tried a lot of different stuff, and the SQL database actually, the Fabric SQL database fits our purpose perfectly.
Thank you so much for sharing your story, Jacob. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you everyone for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget, hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you'd like to see on future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive into Microsoft Fabric.